walk in that she can just look at us and know who we are.
The circumstances that led to Emmalin Nguyen relying on a feeding tube and an oxygen machine for the rest of her life are beyond sad. A lawsuit claims the 18-year-old was left unmonitored for 15 minutes after receiving anesthesia for a breast enhancement procedure. And in that time, she went into cardiac arrest, never to regain consciousness. Her family says Dr. Jeffrey Kim kept mom in the waiting room for more than 5 hours before calling 911.
And the doctor finally came back out to tell me that I wasn't able to go back there to check up on her. But she's still doing fine. She's young. Maybe that's the reason why she's taking longer to wake up.
I just wanted to find out the truth, what happened, and prevent this from happening to other people.
That's what her parents told the problem solvers a month ago. The truth, we're now learning from the state medical board, is staff wanted to call 911 right away, but were ordered by Dr. Kim for more than 5 hours not to.
She's not conscious.
When nurse anesthetist Rex Meeker did finally call 911, he didn't even know the address to share with paramedics.
7180, what's the...
Meeker has voluntarily agreed to no longer practice as a nurse anesthetist, but the state did not touch his RN license. He can still practice as a nurse, he just can't administer anesthesia. According to state documents, Meeker's anesthetic doses may have been inappropriate under the circumstances.
To me, it's beyond awful. It is unconscionable.
David Woodruff is the family's attorney. He credits the state, especially for its emergency action, to suspend Dr. Kim's license.
The board should be commended for that, and it also is it raises huge red flags that the board considers this to be an enormous, enormous problem.
I'm not able to schedule any appointments. Dr. Kim will be out of the office.
A woman still answers the phone when you call Dr. Kim's office to say he's not in, but does not acknowledge why. When we walked in, we had one obvious question.
Can you tell me, why would you guys be open if Dr. Kim's license has been suspended?
No answers from the receptionist, but it could be a long time, if ever, before Dr. Kim sees patients again.
Well, I've always thought this case was a huge travesty. Now it appears to have an element of a doctor actually consciously choosing to deny care to his patient, knowing that she needs to be sent to the hospital.
This afternoon, Dr. Kim's attorney emailed me to say that while this case is tragic for everyone involved, Dr. Kim disputes the claims against him and is cooperating with the board's review. As for his office still being open, it's not a violation. He's not accepting new patients. We simply don't know why. A receptionist continues to work that front desk. Rob Lowe, Fox 31.
All right, Rob.